Yow! Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here with our final math tonight. Cough Arctic. It is tied 1-1 with, the West Coast team choosing to, that isn't, they are on blue, choosing to ban the class that ended up bringing the clutch play for him at the end of that last game, which is Sniper Pythium going big right at the end there, while the East Coast team on red has chosen to ban Soldier. A little bit interesting there. For this third map, I am joined by another Portland Burnsider not playing today. I'm talking about Stagnant Knight. How you doing, Stag?
I'm pretty good.
Good.
I think that Sniper ban on this map is actually one of the stronger ones, because if you look at the huts on both sides of the map, it gives a really good sight line over the point and along that right side out of spawn path, which is really strong for holding down respawns in case the other team does cap.
Yeah, even that left rollout for Sniper as well is not so bad either. A little bit more defensive, but you know, you still get some work done and then just kind of roll your way over to crates and then you got a really good sight line over there.
Yeah.
You played this map with us before, right?
Yes. I played it the last time I PUGged.
Mm-hmm.
I think I was demoing, and demo was really strong along with scout.
Yeah.
And so I'm honestly a bit surprised to see the soldier ban, but I can also see why, because if soldier gets on top of those crates, which is really easy, they can jump around and do some crazy stuff and just spam a lot.
Yeah, I think it's a pretty legit strat. I mean, the explosive classes are so strong that it just makes sense to kind of ban one or the other, you know, when you talk about the mobility that they have. And, you know, Soldier does have those gunboats thanks to the Soldier Demo Man War, which help him out with that mobility.
Yeah, I'm honestly a bit surprised that Blue Team banned Sniper, though, because Pythium was doing well on Sniper last game. He got some good picks. And so, yeah, I'm surprised they didn't ban Demo, considering... Oh, wait, Scrubby's not playing, but if Scrubby was still playing, I would have definitely expected a Demo ban.
Yeah, it does look like Mr. W stepping in for Scrubby. I agree as well, because, you know, part of the dynamic with the ban system is, you know, the pressure that you put on the other team. And I agree with you as well that Blue Team probably could have just tried to burn that on somebody else, you know, ban Engineer and see whether they ban Sniper or not. Either way, it looks like we are live here, and different rollouts. Blue team kind of going hut side while red team trying to take that high ground and control the crate right now.
Yeah, I like how blue team is getting more aggressive, because right now red team's just trapped in that upper right room, so if they can get good demo spam on there, they're almost determined to win the round.
Also,
but they let...
Yeah, I was going to say, the Red Scout pushed forward early. Does get taken out, but Red does then, in response, take the point. They had the quick fix come out early. Critskrieg is out here. Can Nisticow get more crits work done? Well, he gets one, but combined with his teammates, that's three players down. It's just going to be Mr. W, who, died first and died last for his team. West Coast takes a one-round lead here.
Yeah. Did you notice anything about Jerk's loadout on Red?
I saw that he was running some sort of shield.
He's running your favorite, the Tide Turner.
Ooh, he's also running the Mutton Man, so bonus points for that. I do have to point out, because I did run the Persian Persuader. Persian Persuader has the bonus of giving you a bit of health, not like a ton of health when you pick up ammo. But the downside is that you can't pick up ammo. You only get health from ammo. So if you're going to spam out your lock and load, then at some point you're just going to run out of ammo. You can't go back to a closet to resupply, and you're going to get zero ammo, and you're going to be stuck with your melee.
Also, I think that Persian Persuader isn't one of the better choices just because there's less ammo.
Oh my god!
Oh, Jesus. Sick plays from Mystical.
Yeah. Continue.
But the Persian Persuader, since most arena respawn maps don't have as much ammo as like a regular King of the Hill map, the Persian Persuader will only have a limited use to it, and since there's less players total, you're less likely to get ammo pickups, especially if you're playing conservatively.
Yeah, I think that's true, and I mean, it is kind of a pubby weapon. I mean, if you have a medic on your side and your success in the round is determined by your medic, then do you really need that health pickup?
That's kind
of a question.
Yeah.
Right now, we do have heavy weapons guy out for both teams. Demo kind of playing back a little bit while Insom and Blue Jeans playing the heavy weapons guy instead of Pyro, which is a little interesting, but Heavy is a strong pick here, especially with his crit streak. He's doing work, picking up some frags, no problem. Mr. W on the point, but Insom just dodging. He goes down, and it doesn't matter.
Yeah, something that I think changed the momentum of that round is that Jerk, rather than staying with his team, he went under point and did manage to pick off Mystical, but at that point he was just caught out and he had a scout going back for him and he was cleaned up pretty easily. And so I think if he had stayed with his team, it might have been a bit different.
He has switched over to Sticky Bombs. Also, Tide switched over to Kritzkrieg, missing out on that charge though with kind of the issue with respawns and loadouts that we brought up earlier in the last cast. As he's a good 20% behind on this Kritzkrieg.
Yeah. So far, not a whole lot's happening. Both teams are pretty passive, although Blue Team has already capped the point, which isn't a good thing because no one's dead, and now they can't cap it anymore.
Exactly. Insom pops that Kritzkrieg on the heavy weapons guy, who's going to have to try to jump down here, but... he's getting work done. I was going to say, it's not necessarily ideal because there's no way to kind of retreat from that position. But, I mean, they just won the round, so you don't need to retreat. West Coast team up to a 4-0 lead here. Ouch.
It looks like there was some confusion on the bands. Mr. W was sniper for a second.
Oh, that's true. Right, yeah, that's true. It looks like maybe our admins here didn't enforce that ban. But, well, I don't know. He lost the round anyway, so no big deal. Demo switching up to Spy, by the way, to point that out. Running that Enforcer. Trying to get that bonus damage, and we'll see if he can kind of put this loadout into play here. Blue puts a lot of time on.
He is behind the team right now.
Mm-hmm. And we haven't really seen Spy all day today. Oh no! Yeah. Plus, we're about to get Kritzkrieg here on Blue Team. Red Team a little bit behind. And also, Pythium putting some pressure. Is going to be able to sneak away as well, at least so far, with that 20 health. Let's pick up a small bottle over here. If you could get the kill before he dies, it'd be nice, but no, Boba finishes him off. It's going to come down to who gets the better crits here, I think. Mystical up in the air, and might pressure out a slightly earlier crits, but Red staying disciplined, not using it yet. Mystical banged up and falling back.
And the crits comes out for Blue on the heavy with those laser beams, but Red Team has retreated, and now the crits is coming out from Red.
Yeah, definitely going to get the better crits, and oh my god, big pipe, but Jerk still gets the capture. So Nystical, bold moves, but not able to hold it out. Pythia might get this cap uncontested. Gotta play the point. Gotta play the point. Boba, or sorry, wait. We
Jerk could,
somehow
Jerk
have double heavies.
Oh, it's a spawn glitch, I think.
Oh, wow.
Now this is going to be some fun shenanigans. There's a scout on Demo right now. He's dead.
I don't quite know what to say about this. That's the first time I've seen this happen.
Prepare for decimation.
I hope that.
I did call that there was going to be decimation.
It's true. You know, I think the karma came back around. We were playing Highlander earlier. There were shenanigans in one round. There were shenanigans in the other round. You know, and it's like, well, the answer is that we have three rounds. And I think here, you know, we had some double heavy shenanigans. And thankfully, the karma came through and, crushed that. You know, got rid of the double heavy they lost. I don't know if I'm just having some STV round beginning weirdness.
Yeah, I'm lagged out too. I think it might be a pause.
I don't know. Either way, I think the East Coast got what they deserved there. Okay, sounds like we do have a pause here, so at least that's legit. Okay, and then there's
it's over.
There's the respawn, so or sorry, resume.
I think that what Red Team just needs to be doing more is moving as a unit. because right now, sure, they're sticking together, but they're not, at least to me, it seems like they're not really making many decisions as a team. Like, where it looks as if one of them will want to go somewhere, but then another will go somewhere else, and then they'll both end up getting picked off. And it's just putting them at a disadvantage.
I think Arena Respawn even more so than Sixes, I mean, mainly because of the round structure and that you can just lose a round, I mean, so quick off of just one fight. I think Arena Respawn even more so than Sixes, you need to play super tight. In Sixes, if you're playing the flank and then your flank player goes down, it's like, oh, okay, well, we'll just back up a little bit and then we'll get the respawn. But it's not the case here in Arena Respawn, despite it being in the name.
Mr. W actually picked off both Pythium and Insomnia this round. And so blue team is at a significant disadvantage.
Although Demo very low, he is still surviving, and his team is doing
well.
Oh,
he's on top of point.
Oh my.
Is he going to get it?
I think he might. Yes, he does. He might even just finish the round here if he can get a pipe kill. If he goes down, then Jerk can... Oh!
Mystical.
Huge. Oh, I think that was... Okay, no, that was a 4-kill. That was still pretty huge. But a solid 4K from Nisticow there, and that puts them within one round of just ending the game here. They're going to ride the wave of Pythium's map-winning snipe and possibly get a 7-0 mercy rule here on Koth Arctic.
Yeah. At this point, like, they just should have played closer, and it's just falling apart for Red.
It is, it is. As a Mr. W just runs in early, goes down. Red's getting some work done here, but Blue's going to get the respawn, which is going to set them up. There goes Boba. It is just Jerk. okay, it looked like he was like, do I jump? Do I kill
Please
myself?
you know,
what do I do?
In.
He needs to just, oh, he doesn't even know there's a bottle right over there. What a jerk.
Oh, I think he sees that mini bottle.
I mean, he should have grabbed the mini bottle, but I don't know where he's going now. He's going for the bottle on top of crate. He already walked past the one bottle.
He might be going for the bottle under point, actually, because it's a... Oh, he's jumping in 5 health! The dream was crushed.
The dream was very solidly crushed there by the West Coast team. As that does it. West Coast takes it 2-1, and, you know... Oh, I'm not going to say it right now, but, you know, we do have an allusion to the coast in our server password and the West Coast. Well, they're going to keep that in there, keep that reference as they just stomped on this last map here.
Yeah, something I've noticed about this map is that most times when I've played it in Arena Respawn, if there's one team with an explosive class that's putting out more damage and they're doing it a lot, that team's going to win. Like, last time I played, Demo wasn't banned, and my team was able to put out a ton of damage using Demo, and then our scout would just capitalize on every single one of those picks, and that's what was happening on blue team, because Nistical would be putting out a lot of damage, and then the rest of his team would capitalize.
Mm-hmm.
And that just wasn't really there on red.
Yeah, Nistical with those crits, I mean, a couple of those rounds were won solely off of that. The 4K that he had, and then the other 4K that he had.
Yeah.
You know, like, I mean, it's 5v5. If you're hitting 4Ks, then it's pretty solid. It's going to help you out.
That's also part of the, like, challenge to playing in such a tight group in fives, specifically AR, is that if the other team is running crits, and they crits their demo, and, like, four players on your team are in, like, within 10 feet of each other, there's a high chance that they're all going to die just because you can't really do much against that because you're all bunched up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that definitely makes a big difference, and Nisticow was able to come through with it, but also the blue jeans on the heavy weapons guy was interesting in the sense that blue jeans is renowned in our Arena Respawn circle for being very strong on pyro, and blue team just, I mean, for one, they banned the class that won them the last map, and for two, blue jeans was just like, you didn't ban pyro and I'm gonna run heavy full time. So some interesting decisions that certainly paid out for the West Coast.
I actually think that the heavy choice was a lot better than the pyro choice on this
map. I agree.
Just
yeah,
because it's a lot more useful for there to be a heavy, because the range is just so much more than a pyro, and you don't want to have your pyro running in and dying because like they just don't have the range meant for this map.
Yeah, I think you did definitely have to run a heavy weapons guy here. You know, maybe they could have run blue jeans on pyro and power dusk on heavy. But the engineer is also very helpful because you can, you know, there's a lot of really good spots that you can place a mini sentry, as well as the pressure that you can put on point. And there's a couple nooks, like, you know, around the point where you can drop a mini sentry and it has good protection. You know, it's able to shoot and cover a good amount of area without being really vulnerable from long range or needing to be wrangled or just safely tucked away overall.
Yeah, I was actually kind of surprised that neither team really went for the medium pack under point, because while you can get flanked if you're at a numbers disadvantage if you go under point, it's still one of the better ways to push if the team isn't expecting it. Because last time I played, the enemy team would push through under point with like their heavy med and a pyro, and then our team would get decimated because we didn't have the numbers behind us to really fight that.
Yeah, that's true. And you know, Badlands and Sixes, you call it the submarine push. You know, you just go right underneath and push through with a lot of players, and you know while the other team is like, where'd they go? Where are they? Then all of a sudden you just roll in with all five, and that's a very strong push, a very strong tactic, and I think that they could have gone through that, but nope, they did not. Well, Stack, thanks for joining me, man. Any last words, sorry?
I think this was fun.
good. I had a lot of fun as well, especially the end of that second map. Wow, what a finish. And, we're going to have some more games on Thursday night. We'll see if those get broadcasted. I'll be here for the UGC, and then we'll probably do the same stuff that we did today, where broadcasting UGC with Dashner, and then I'll take over for the Arena Respawn. If you want more information on Arena Respawn, please check out the Arena Respawn Steam group, as well as Pro Battle League, that are helping to organize this and are planning to organize more Arena Respawn competitions in the future. Also, want to give a huge shout out to Land Vegas Nerd Year's Eve. It's going to be happening from December 29th all the way up to, well, New Year's. And going to be a really fun event held in coordination with SkillCon. The LAN itself is going to be overlooking SkillCon. Ticket to the lands is $30. Got to make it out to Vegas, but hey, we're going to have a ton of fun out there and should be a blast. Thanks to some support from ModMic, which is a wonderful company that produces microphones that you can collapse onto your fantastic headphones that you already own. We're going to be having our production guy, Dashner, will be making it out there. And should be a wonderful show for you guys throughout those couple of days. We're lining up the details on the pro players that we're trying to get out there. We're going to bring two top-level teams out to compete in Ulti Duo. And, all the other people that are showing up and buying tickets will be in that tournament. $2,000 on the line. $1,200 for first place, $600 for second place, and $300 for third place, as well as cash money prizes for MGE Soldier and Scout tournaments. So that's it for us, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks so much for tuning in. Hope you guys had a blast. I am eXtine, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.